source of misconception of religion among masses and religious repetitions, authored by myself, ABUBAKKAR SIDHIQ and ALIDA. It is a conceptual study that does analysis of various literature, which include research articles, journals, books, movies, and YouTube channels, commercial advertisement, which gives the theme of the title. The whole paper focuses on the need of the deconstruction of the meaning of religion through finding out all the misconceptions existing about the religion among the people, especially in the country of pluralistic reality. It studies cause-effect relationship between wrong interpretation and internalization of religiosity, masquerading as a divine religious rituals and beliefs which claim to be a part of great culture, and the related repercussions happen in the socio-political and cultural sphere. This is done through the probing into various critical artistic expressions of religion and controversies raised by the which are meant to be followed communal harmony and effective integration. The white sociological theorists such as Emily Durkheim, Max Weber, Karl Marx view religion as an illusion of talk about the influence of cultures and location on religion, inability of religion to present fundamental truth of existence. They also speculated a gradual increase in the influence of religion, of definition of religion. One cannot deny the fact that religion is a part of individual cultures and religion of itself is culture. According to Gerber and Enesky, religion is a thought, a system of belief about the nature of forces ultimately shaping man's destiny and practice and associated therewith are shared by members of the groups, unquote. In common people, understanding religious beliefs, religious denomination, strength of religious demonstration linked with the cultural beliefs and background. This is a new much through which the interpretation process to religious ideologies practiced, however, this lies to a different concept. There are various artistic expressions which contribute to pertinent to many religions. That is, example, in 2018 January, Shashi Tharoor released the book Why I Am a Hindu. That is saying that we are proud to be as a Hindu. If you choose wrong things, that is your choice. Don't blame Hinduism. Hinduism is offer you alternative choice. If you are good Hindu or Muslim, not eating adopt the Hindu or Muslim, vice versa. He is saying Hindutva is a political ideology. It is really not a religion interpretation. It is a political ideology and itself on a hook that embrace all one religion who follow that area. The law of Manu is a very rigid and misogynist anti-lower caste. September 2019, 1 month back, released again one book titled The Hindu Way, an introduction to Hinduism. In there, he quoting the Swami and the word as a religion, not just a tolerance but also acceptance, unquote. Acceptance nobler than tolerance. My Hinduism is a religion of the tolerance. 2010, Perumal Murugan released a book titled One Part Woman about the ancient custom from Tiruchinagod that allowed childless women sexual relationship between the first day of temple festival. After that, some so-called nationalists campaign against him, telling his anti-religious inserting beliefs of then stopped fighting for 2 years. 2019 June in Jaipur Literature Festival, interview with Quint Channel, he said that threat of freedom of speech and artist expression, the because of our sentiment, we cannot try village living out of from the caste system, is there wherever we see it. Reality to this only we can't out from the caste discrimination. It was 17 January 10, the assistant professor of the University of New Jersey, Howdy Tuskin, is written the book titled Aurangzeb, the Man of the Myth. The 4 pages in the book appear in India because of this anti-religion nature set to national integration. The Aurangzeb as a being always portrayed history as a Mughal king who demolished temple and attacked Hindu, etc. After her deep research, she concluded that the most bigoted among the Mughal empire is not a kind of guy who just disseminated temple, attacked Hindu. he protected more temple and given finance to build it. He sport a military that many Hindus poet as scholars. Malik Muhammad Jaisi, the famous Sufi poet, 18th century, author of famous book Padmavat, which inspired to Sanjay Lavansar in the galactic Padmavat movie, which released on 25 January 2018. Before releasing the movie, he got threatened from so-called nationalist group who have their national wide protest and offered money for visiting director at Rajni. Due to this religious group, started violence through the both religions, Hinduism and Christianity, and Muslim, both are. 2017, April 20th, the Praya Akbar, authoring novel titled Laila, the inspired director Deepa Mehta to release the Laila series part of one Netflix. Laila was the story of India in 2049 when a powerful man, Joshi, rules over entire nation, the country divided on the name of religion and caste, where minority a secondary class citizen with digitalized nation called Aryavarta. The director said if Laila has been filmed, never got released because of the government and radicalized group. The Laila argued that I can't deny the reality it depicts to the nation of future of present. The former Vice Chancellor of the MP University, Professor Kulabargi, spoke against the idol worship in Hinduism. So he fought death by Karnataka to the right wing party. The poet author, journalist Gauri Lankesh, she is martyred by the some extremist group by Parashurama Vakmore, June 16.2, SID, Gauri Lankesh killed for freedom my religion. The detergent brand Surfexer released the new Holi campaign, rising the Hindu-Muslim unity group kids and a place to attack to this focusing for the Gauziya. There is a conclusion now. This is an impending need of future generation to be a pluralistic in mind and coexistence of multiple regions is the new pluralistic reality. People should undergo change of faith is offering of existing pluralism. The idea of all human beings are equal and accepting the truth of needs and entity of the common is known over the religion. It will make people obey and their power to it. All religious scripture speaks about the value of the tolerance, mutual understanding, but problem is that how far people bring this greater ideology to partial life. We are kind of extraordinary diversity that very few countries possess. There we have quite ethnic mix. We have a language, religion, habit, life of eating habit, customs, all of the which differ from the part of country to another, from one India to another. And we are treated as common than Indians. A shared geography, a shared history, or sustained democracy that gives us to aspiration of future. To do what? To maintain that, to build on it. If you are Hindu or Muslim vulnerable, if you are Tamilian Kerala vulnerable, you will get a protection from the constitution, institution, democracy, equal rights. All gives you your place, even every possible future. The great things about India, if you can to be a same type, like to any good Muslim or Hindu or Buddhist, or to good Kannadiga or Tamil or Punjabi, or good Indian at all at once. Humans should be a free judgment about the what they drink, eat, wear, what their occupation, where they live, and with whom. They co-deciding about all what their beliefs. Ultimate religion should liberate one individual rising into higher position of greater human rights. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now we have the last speaker, Ashwati Bohan, research scholar.